wear my crown. Wear it how you want, girl. Show it all gone, girl. I'll wear my crown. My hair, my crown. My hair, my crown. Wear it how you want, girl. Show it all gone, girl. My hair, my crown. My hair, my crown.
People gon' talk, always got opinions. Gon' let my head down, I ain't gotta hear 'em.
Peace, family. Welcome back to Align with Plants, episode 4. Yeah. Today we are going to be talking about hair. We're actually going to be talking about locks. You see, I have my crown on today. I shaved my head about 4 years ago. I actually shaved my first set of locks about 4 years ago and have been growing this new set out the last 4 years using just plants. We're in the shop right now. I'm going to go ahead and put together a tea blend that is great for healthy hair. And introduce you to a few herbal friends of mine. I have a couple of big heavy hitters here with me today, mineral rich herbs that are great for building blood, for circulation, and definitely for hair. Moringa, we have moringa in the house. You guys can see this, I've gotta get a better zoom. My zoom's gotta get better, but we got moringa in the house, you can't see that. Nutrient dense, rich in calcium, proteins, minerals. Great for the cardiovascular system, natural energy boost, and super anti-inflammatory as well. We're gonna put a couple of tablespoons of moringa. So my hair has always been thin, and I'm just aware that thinning hair does run in my family. I wanna make sure that I'm supporting myself with nutrient-rich diet as well as herbs to support my locks because I love them, and I think I'm pretty sure I'm a locked for life girl. All right, second herb is dandelion leaf. That's the second one I'm adding in. Super blood purifier. Dandelion leaf is great for the blood, great for circulating the blood and moving the blood throughout the body, which is really where your healthy hair is gonna come from, right? It's having healthy blood movement and circulation, moving oxygen into the scalp and into the skin as well. Also gonna be adding horsetail, a plant, an herb that is silica rich. I was able to wild harvest horsetail just last year along a beautiful river bed in northern Arizona. It grows pretty much anywhere there's a lot of water, or not necessarily a whole lot of water, but it's gonna do really well by a lot of water. I've actually found it in San Diego in Southern California quite a bit as well, even in an apartment complex that my sister lived in. Horsetail is great for skin, hair, nails, even teeth. It helps produce collagen. It's actually full of silica, and that's gonna be really important for hair because our hair is made of silica, made of collagen. All right, the last herb we're gonna do is red clover. Red clover is a legume that grows very low to the ground, kind of like a grass. But we're talking about clover, the four-leaf clover, if you're lucky to find one. Clover, especially the flowers, are great for building blood, great for cleansing our blood, and great for, again, stimulation. Really, all of these plants are doing kind of the same thing, but gonna be great for stimulating my blood and getting oxygen into my scalp and keeping things young and supple, right? All right, let me show you all my beautiful. All right, so this is a loose leaf tea. I will drink this a couple different ways. I'll do a hot brew and have this in the evening, and then I'll also do an overnight cold brew and allow the herbs to slowly penetrate into the water and then drink on that for a few days. In today's video, I am gonna walk you through how I take care of my crown with plants. I have a very simple hair care regimen. It includes a basic apple cider vinegar rinse or wash. I use a crochet hook to tighten my locks, so no product twisting or recombining of the locks. And I put very, very little bitty oil on my hair or on my scalp. I keep things very simple, very basic, allow my skin to thrive and be healthy from the inside out by focusing on herbs, herbal supplements, and of course, primarily my diet. A lot of water, a lot of whole food juices I'm actually cleansing right now, and a ton of colorful fruits and vegetables. That's gonna be what's really important, right, is that our daily diet includes a ton of plants, our body with the appropriate amount of minerals and vitamins and nutrients that we need to thrive, because actually the human is extremely resilient and made to survive on Earth. So when I was 25, I decided to lock my hair. I locked, that first set of lock was a crazy set, but I did it and I was really proud of myself. There was a lot of breaking up with vanity and, you know, certain ideas that women have about how they have to look to be beautiful or sexy. That was a lot tied into that hair. I also, for the first time, had left home. Had left my home state and had begun to explore a vast new world. So my first set of locks had to do a lot with that. But after 7 years of having that set of locks, I came to a divine realization that I had to shave them off all the way. I put my children to sleep one day. I told them I'd have a surprise for them when they woke up, and their surprise was this. Bald head mom. They were not happy at all with me, but I was free, I was reborn, and I knew I would lock again, but I was gonna grow my hair out inch by inch and experience the full totality of being a woman with no hair and quite frail and pale at the time. We were living in the Pacific Northwest, and I wasn't getting a lot of sun, and I wasn't eating a lot, and I was just going through massive transformations of self. So I grew my hair out. It was quite a process. My children got used to it. My babies got used to it. And I did too. I liked the little short phase. As the curls grew out though, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do with it. I didn't really like how it looked. So as soon as it got long enough to where I had to decide to fade the back of it, I decided I was gonna lock it back up, I'm gonna snatch this hair up, put it in some locks, and just wear it covered. So I did that. I wore it covered for the next, gosh, like, I don't know, 7, 8, maybe 9 months. I did this with my first set as well, just wore a scarf over it every day. I didn't get super adventurous with my scarves. I wore the same scarves. Because it was kind of, you know, like a they're formative days, you know, when your locks are forming, these are, you know, ground laying foundational days. And when it was time to bring them out, I think about 9 months after locking back up, they were itty bitty little things, but I had locks and I was excited. So I would wear them on and off, covered and uncovered, slowly began to wear them uncovered more and more, and they slowly began to creep down my shoulder, down my neck and down my shoulders, down to my shoulders. And now, 4 years later, I'm just so excited. They have now reached to like below the bra strap on my back. Really impressed with the growth, even myself. I've had locks, this is my second set, but I feel like this set is just growing even quicker than the first, and they are healthier, and they are just, I just love it. I'm in love with this set. So I want to walk you all through how I wash my hair, how I tighten my locks, how I actually use the crochet needle to actually bring the hairs back in and tighten them up, and then also how I put together this beautiful crown and show you how simple it is, how diverse locks are as well. You know, people don't even realize how diverse the hairstyle is. So I'm gonna show you how I put this updo together within, you know, a few moments, and show you how to take care of your locks and even your regular hair with plants. So I do a pretty simple mixture, and this is what I've been washing my hair with for quite a few years now. I do a raw apple cider vinegar. I'm gonna use Bragg's brand. I love their brand, organic. It's all raw, it has the mother in it. This is a living, you know, cleanser. Vinegar is an amazing cleanser that can be used for just about anything. I'm gonna be using a couple different therapeutic grade essential oils added into the vinegar. I know that is not clearly focused, but that says rosemary. I love doTERRA brand.
Therapeutic grade is 100% pure and natural, and that's the only grade that I use on my body. We're gonna do one little squirt of a liquid soap to help break up the oil and put it all into a handy dandy spray bottle. I'm gonna dilute the apple cider vinegar. 3/4 of that spray bottle is going to be vinegar, and 1/4 of it is going to be distilled water or spring water. I'm gonna pour it directly in so that the vinegar is diluted. You can, you know, use it undiluted, but it's very strong and powerful, and when I'm doing a really strong strip, I will do it undiluted, but normally for my regular upkeep, I'm gonna do it like this. 5 drops of rosemary, therapeutic grade only essential oil, is gonna go in. Do 5 drops, 5 drops of tea tree essential oil, again, therapeutic grade only. The tea tree oil is antiviral, going to keep the locs nice and fresh. The rosemary is anti-inflammatory as well as good for actually hair promotion or hair growth. One tiny little squirt of liquid soap is gonna go in. And you know, oil and water don't mix, so the soap comes in and helps break the oils up and move them throughout the entire liquid. So when I'm spraying it onto my head, I'm actually getting the full effect of the oil in each spray. Shake it up, and there we go. That's my no poo shampoo. I've been using it for quite a while and it works really well. All right guys, look at my crazy hair. It is time for a wash and a retwist. This is 4 years of growth now. I'm really proud of my locks. I love this set. That's 4 years long coming from that bald head. This is a set that's gonna stay with me for a while. I decided I wouldn't cut these for 14 years. So we'll see how long they get. Before I wash my hair, I always massage my scalp a little bit. This is a face roller, and I have tried massaging my scalp with this face roller. It felt amazing. I highly recommend getting a face roller in general in your life, but using it on your scalp, OMG. When you have locks, you don't actually touch your scalp as often as you do if you brush or comb your hair every day. And so the small oil glands under your, underneath your skin on your scalp actually need to be massaged so that that oil can be released. So I do that periodically throughout my hair or throughout my style, but also right before I twist up, which all those little hairs there you see need to be put back into the locks. So after I have drenched my hair, I'm now taking my vinegar and slowly but consistently spraying it all along my scalp. The vinegar is a natural cleanser, right? So it is actually cleansing and not stripping the hair. It's breaking the oils down and the water is rinsing them out, but keeping also the natural, balance of my natural oils. So vinegar gets a really, really good cleanse on my scalp and in my locks, but doesn't make it feel like that squeaky clean, you know, feeling. That's not what I want. So I take my time, I spray that entire bottle all over my scalp, a little bit here, a little bit there, and also along the bottoms of the hair as well, or the ends of my locks as well. Saturate the entire scalp, the entire hair of that entire, or that whole bottle of vinegar. And that is my shampoo, guys. That's literally how I've been washing my hair now for 12 years. Every once in a while, I'll use a clarifying conditioner and a clarifying shampoo and wash my hair with that as well, but this has been the primary way that I've washed my hair. Really good rinse is necessary. You definitely want to get as much of that vinegar that you can out, or you will smell a little bit like a salad dressing, which while the locks are drying, you kind of get that smell a little bit, but it doesn't ever bother me. And by the time they dry, you do not smell the vinegar at all. So really good rinse. Make sure that you rinse all of it out. And also that little squirt of soap is in there too. So I want to make sure that I spend time, because anything in locks, you know, any type of chemical creation that you put into your locks, especially like a liquid soap, will build up over time. So I make sure that I get it all out, do a nice little twist. I don't want to twist it too much. Don't want to break off the locks, but there you go. That's how I wash my hair. All right, all done. I have gone ahead and applied some creosote oil onto my face. And let's go ahead and check out how clean these are, how it looks. Sometimes I do get out and I decide to actually go back in and wash them one more time. But this felt really good. My scalp felt super refreshed. I loved using that face roller beforehand. My scalp was literally tingling right now because I had opened up all those pores with that face roller. That was an amethyst face roller or skin roller. And man, my scalp was tingling. It felt so good and so rejuvenated. You can see very, very clean up at the root. I absolutely love it. You can use this on regular loose hair as well. You know, you can see at the bottom of my locks here, my curls, they are nice and clean. It works great on curly hair, straight hair, if it's loose or locked up. All right, guys, it is time to get these bad boys twisted back up. I am patiently waiting. This is the crochet needle that I use here, and it does take a while. It takes a couple of hours to go through this, and sometimes my hands get tired, and even as I do more and more things with my hands in my career, my hands get tired from doing my hair. So I don't try to do it too much, but you can see all these little hairs, they start to get crazy. I prefer how my hair looks when it is done, but you know, honestly, I just don't have the time to keep them retwisted every week. And also, it's not good to over twist your locks. If you over twist your locks or even over crochet your locks, they will get weak at the root, and over time they will not grow as well. So I'm going to crochet those little hairs at the top of the lock, and also these hairs that I'm pulling on the lock. I'm literally going to take my crochet needle and crochet all of those hairs back into the lock versus twisting it and using any type of product. This is a technique that's going to be good for fine hair or straighter hair like mine. You see, that is the texture of my hair in the back. And that's baby hair that I shaved off, but it grew back exactly how it has always grown my entire life. So I can't put those hairs by my ear or in front of my ear or behind on my neck into locks. They'll come right out. They're just unruly hairs, and they do what they want to do, which is stay out. So, all right, but so you can see, I'm grabbing all the loose hairs around the base of the lock and pulling them into my hand, because I'm actually going to take that, all those loose hairs, and wrap it around the base of the lock. So all those hairs were the ones that were sticking up. They're out of the way, or they're in the way. A lot of times people would palm roll them or twist that new hair into the lock and then put some type of a product on the outside to keep it, to keep the hairs in place. Instead of that, we're gonna take this crochet needle, push it through the lock, wrap the hair around the crochet needle, and then literally pull that hair back through the lock, like so. So no need for product to keep the hair, you know, next to the lock. We're actually weaving it back into the lock step by step. And it is the best thing yet. I've seen a lot of locks get done. And you know, there's a lot of great techniques out there, but I have, you know, I took over my partner's locks. He had his locks for, gosh, he's had them for like 16 years now. I watched his first set that were all palm rolled basically get brittle and fall apart over the years because they were too thin. And the twisting can, depending on the size of the locks and how often you twist it and if you put product in and et cetera, and the type of hair, can get weak because of the twisting. The curls are literally weak and are not strong. So they break off over time, and you'll have some people have locks for 7 to 10 years and they don't get the good length. So this is a way that you can guarantee length because you're not twisting the locks. You're actually taking the hairs and reinforcing the lock by wrapping it around that little crochet needle and pulling it back into the lock. So it's really, really simple. It strengthens your locks. It is a way that you can actually keep them cleaner longer because you're not going to be twisting them. So let's go, it's time. check on Sally. Looks like she is still hibernating. She's getting ready to shed her skin. I wonder if she knows we're watching Moana. She's a pretty cool snake. We just got her a new house, more space. Sally the snake. Moana's like the best Disney movie ever too. I don't know if you guys know that, but if you haven't watched Moana, watch it now. All right guys, so I'm like halfway done now. I think that the movie is already over, and I still have quite a few more locks to do. But by this point, my hand has kind of gotten into the groove of it, and I'm moving pretty quickly. But you can see on my left side that it's starting to look much cleaner, much more put together. Soon I will have a completed head of locks. Wait until I get to this point every time. Final lock, the last one, the best advice I ever remember Biggie Smalls giving. If you know East Coast 90s hip hop, is treat every project like it's your first project. And I feel that way about my locks. I treat every lock like it's the first lock. I like to go all the way to the end and make sure that I've taken care of every single lock, make sure that all the little hairs that I can see are pushed back in. So I take my time and finish. But we are on the final stretch. This is it. You can see the smile on my face. I'm excited. My hands and my arms are tired. And now I know I'll be good for at least another 2, maybe 3 weeks of not having to actually retwist them. And I'll wash it again next week. Actually, I wash my hair every 7 to 10 days or so. All right, we are all done. Yay! So excited. You can see all of the hairs have been threaded back into the locks. The top is super clean. I think if my scalp gets tanned, we won't see as much of the scalp. But you can tell, nice and clean. Looks like they're twisted, but they're not. All of the hairs have been pushed back in. You see those baby hairs will not go in, so I just leave them alone. And that's just a part of my style. That's how I rock my locks. All right, so that's 4 years of growth, guys. And with plants, no product, with a crochet needle, nice, strong, healthy locks. Let me show you how I wrap it up into a crown. All right, so I like to start my crown from the back so that I can actually keep a balanced crown on both sides. If I start on one side, then like the bulk of the hair will be on one side or the other, and it's a little bit off balance. So if you're gonna be doing one single crown, start from the back and just do a slow roll, slowly collecting each of the hairs along the hairline. It's going to be the locks that are along the hairline that really hold the crown up against the hairline so that it's a crown here in the front of the head versus like more shifting towards the back. So you want to roll that stack of hair along the front of the hairline and keep those front locks kind of as a guidepost and as the major hooks, you know, like if you can see those ones in my front, they're literally hooked around. And I've really created the crown shape. The cool thing with locks is you can just tuck them in. So as I keep going around and rolling and tucking in little flyaway locks, I come around to the back, and as I continue to roll and roll, I tuck that into the first part of the roll, the part of the roll that I started originally. I just roll it on in, bob and weave. bob and weave brings back childhood memories, but tuck in all the little curls. Get your crowns right, ladies? Crowns up. I'm so excited that I was able to hang out with you guys today and share how I take care of my locks with plants. Make sure that you tune in next week. New episodes are dropping every week of Align with Plants. And until then, put your crowns on, ladies.